After breaking down the web page we want to create, we get to the main section. This section has two main parts itself. Each of these two parts also have additional parts within them. In this lecture, we'll show you how to organize this main section using semantic elements like section, article, and aside. Hello guys, welcome again. Alright, let's begin with the section element. The section tag is used to group related content on a web page. We should only use it if there isn't a more specific element available. Also, sections should always have a heading, except for a few cases. For example, a navigation menu is a section, but it should be wrapped in a nav element. On the other hand, a list of search results or products doesn't have specific elements, so it can be placed inside a section. Okay, on our page, we have two areas with multiple blocks of related content. We can replace the div tags with section tags to group that content. If we inspect the page, we can see that section acts like div with a display block style by default from the browser. But unlike div, the section helps organize the page into meaningful sections. Alright, let's move on. In the first section, there are three separate sections. Each section is independent, but also connected to each other because they are all about programming tutorials. The best element we can use here instead of div is the article tag. Article is for independent pieces of content that make sense on their own. For example, a blog post, newspaper article, product card, or user comment can be placed within an article tag. In our page, each of these tutorials are separate and independent. So let's change the three divs to article tags instead. Okay, section and article tags are important elements for organizing web page content. It's important to understand how they work for building well-structured pages. We should use the section tag to group related content together, and we should use the article tag to define individual pieces of independent and self-contained content. Okay, in the right section, we have some independent pieces of content that each introduce a future tutorial. Let's put them in article tags as well. Now, let's inspect the page and check its default CSS properties. As you can see, just like div, the semantic tags take the display block styling from the browser. Okay, up until now, all the semantic tags we introduced are displayed the same as div, but their meanings are different for developers, search engines, and screen readers. Alright, in our page, the main content is about the tutorials. But on the right side, we inform users about future tutorials. So, the best sectioning element here is aside, instead of section. The aside element represents content that is indirectly related to the main content. This means they contain additional information that is not required to fully understand the main content. These tags are frequently used as sidebars. Now, let's replace the right section with an aside tag. Okay, let's inspect the page again and check its default CSS properties. As you can see, the aside tag also takes the display block styling from the browser. To finish up, remember that section and article tags can be nested inside each other. You can also include other article tags within an article. It's up to you to use these tags based on how you structure your content. The SI tag works the same. You can place it in different parts of the page. For example, you could have an SI even within a paragraph. The only thing to be careful of is that its content should be indirectly related to the main content and only provide additional information. The content inside a thread should not be required to understand the main part of the page. Okay, done. See you soon.